Validating is an important part of mapping on OpenStreetMap, especially in projects with the humanitarian OpenStreetMap team or missing maps, where remote volunteers contribute to the map. The Red Cross and other humanitarian groups need accurate, complete data for their work, and that's where validators play an important role. The idea is that after remote or armchair volunteers map an area, other volunteers double-check the data. They take a look to make sure everything has been mapped properly, that nothing is missing, things are tagged correctly, and so on. To be a validator, it's best that you already have some experience mapping out OpenStreetMap, and on humanitarian OpenStreetMap tasks in particular. If you do, that's great. Please watch on. If you are still fairly new, it's recommended that you do not start validating yet, but with more experience, you can. To get started, go to tasks.hotosm.org and log in with your OpenStreetMap account. Then choose a task to help validate. If you know what task you'd like to work on, search for it. The tasks are sorted by priority. The percentage next to the name of the task indicates how much of that task has been completed or validated. The orange portion is how much has been completed, and the green portion is how much has been validated. Tasks that are mostly done with a mostly orange status bar are good to choose to validate. When you've chosen your task to validate, the process is similar to using the Tasking Manager to map. The orange squares are the ones that have been marked as done, and the green squares are the ones that have been marked as complete and validated. You will be working on the orange squares. Each task is different, so read the description and instructions carefully and check any tagging guides and references that are linked first. Then, choose an orange square to validate by clicking on it. Once your square is selected, click Review the Work and choose your editor of choice. ID Editor is the default browser-based editor. JOSM is a more advanced editor. If you know how to use JOSM, use that. Otherwise, use ID. Now, zoom into your square. It's important to zoom in because some features may be hidden at far-out zoom levels. Start browsing through the square, making sure that everything mentioned in the instructions is mapped, and is mapped correctly. For example, if it's a building task, make sure the buildings are tagged properly and their corners are squared. In many tasks, you're supposed to tag buildings just as a generic building, but sometimes people use tags like house or other things improperly. Make sure to check on that. Also make sure buildings don't overlap each other or connect to roads. If something is connected but shouldn't be, click on the vertex that joins them, then click on the button that looks like two arrows to split them apart. Then square the building corners by pressing the S key on your keyboard. If it's a roads task, make sure the roads have the proper classification. It's not good if a small farm track is tagged as a motorway, for example. Make sure roads that intersect are actually connected to each other as well, like so. There will be a gray circle meaning the two roads are connected. If everything in the square looks complete and correct, go back to the Tasking Manager window and leave a comment in the comment box. You should thank those who've worked on the square so far by typing the @ key on your keyboard and then their username. You can see the list of people who've worked on the task below. There may have been many people who contributed, so make sure to thank them all for their work. This can encourage them to come back and map again. Then after you've left your comment, click Validate. That square has been validated, and you can move on to another. You might find some issues. In this case, one building overlaps the road, some of the buildings don't have square corners, and one isn't tagged at all. If some things are missing or not tagged properly in a square, you have a few options. Either fix them yourself and validate the square, or invalidate the square and leave it so others can come back and fix it. It's up to you. Often fixing it yourself can be faster, but asking others to fix it can make it more of a learning moment for them. In either of those cases, go back to the Tasking Manager window in your browser and leave a note for those who've contributed. Make sure to thank them, but also suggest what else needs to be done or what they can do next time nicely. If you choose not to fix the problems yourself, click the Invalidate button. This will make the square turn gray, which means it's invalidated. Even if the data has a lot of problems, please be friendly and respectful. We want to make sure that people come back to volunteer again. Here's a list of features to be on the lookout for when validating. Make sure to read the description and instructions as well to see if there's any additional things to look for.